Hey guys, and welcome back to Mork's Menu. So normally when I post my videos, I try and not do the exact same type of video back to back, but when I saw that Taco Bell is going to be removing some of their classics from their menu starting in August, and there's rumors that the quesarito might be on it, or that it's going to be limited on how you can order it or something like that, I figured this would be a good time to go ahead and test out this recipe that I've had on my Pinterest for a while. So with that being said, today's video is another copycat restaurant recipe. As always, if you have not yet followed me on Instagram, make sure you follow me there and subscribe if you're new to my channel, and let's go ahead and get started. All right, as per usual, I'll go over the ingredients that we're all gonna need. It's fairly straightforward, but I did find this recipe via Delish, one of the big ones that's all over Facebook and everything. So I'll link the recipe that I'm following down below. Okay, so if you are familiar with the quesarito, you know it's basically just a burrito with a quesadilla for the burrito part. So basically just some extra cheese, extra carbs and tortillas added onto a burrito. So there are obviously a couple different moving parts that we're going to need to put together to get this all into one quesarito. So the first thing is the quesadilla part of it. So we're just going to be using some simple flour tortillas. You want to make sure that you get the large burrito size because we are going to have to fold these, especially once it's thick. It's going to be a little bit hard to do if you had a small tortilla, so just get the biggest one. And then obviously we're going to need just some cheese to go on the inside of that. You could add more if you wanted to, but I'm just going to add this soy cheese blend from Trader Joe's. It's shredded cheddar, mozzarella, and jack flavor cheeses. You can use just cheddar, whatever you want to do. You just need something to make the inside of the quesadilla. For the insides of the burrito, you're going to want to also cook up some rice. So I'm just making mine in my rice cooker. You want about half a cup per the number of quesarritos that you are making. And then I'm going to add a little bit of lime juice and cilantro in with the rice once it is cooked. And then the last thing you'll need to cook is whatever meat of choice that you want inside the quesarito. I'm going to do just kind of classic ground beef. So I just have some normal ground beef. Again, I'm going to do about a quarter of a pound per serving, so I'm going to make about half a pound of ground beef, and then you can season it with whatever taco seasonings that you want. The recipe calls for paprika and chili powder, cumin, as well as salt and pepper. And then I'm also going to be adding onion powder and garlic powder because, as I've mentioned, I add that to everything. And then the last two things you're going to need, which don't take any prep, but you're going to need some sour cream, as well as some nacho cheese sauce, salsa con queso, just kind of the fake yellow cheese to go in the middle. So you guys know how to make rice. I'm not going to worry about showing that to you. I went ahead and got that going as my first thing, just cooking up in my rice cooker. The next thing I'm going to do is go ahead and start on the quesadillas, just because I don't want them to be too hot when I'm trying to fold them up later. So I'm going to go ahead and get those started once I'm almost done with both quesadillas. I'm then going to start browning the meat and seasoning it. And then once we have all the components cooked and ready to go, I'll check back in and show you how we're going to assemble everything. Alrighty, so now we have our station of everything set out here. So we have our two quesadillas. I am letting them cool a little bit before I assemble them just so they're not too hot to touch. So just keep that in mind. You probably do want to make your quesadillas first like I did, so you don't try and burn your hands or have to wait too long. But I also have my rice that's already cooked here. So I'm gonna go ahead and add a little bit of lime juice. Probably about, I don't know, maybe a tablespoon. You don't want too much because again, we only made a cup of cooked rice, which is less than two servings. And then I'm gonna add just a little bit of cilantro. I would normally add a lot more, but Mitch doesn't really like it. So I'm just gonna add a tiny, tiny bit for flavor, but I don't wanna make it to where he doesn't like it. All right, so there's that. So that's gonna be our first layer. I'm gonna go ahead and throw that down as the base. Next layer we're gonna add is our beef. So if you have a pretty high fat content in your beef, you're gonna wanna drain it out. I cook with 93.7 typically, just cause that's normally what we have in the freezer. So mine's pretty good, but make sure you do drain it if needed. All right, and the last two things that I'm gonna add to kind of go like the original is a little bit of nacho cheese and sour cream. So you basically wanna do kind of one part sour cream to one part cheese. I'm gonna do about a little less than 2 tablespoons of sour cream and 4 tablespoons of the nacho cheese sauce. Alrighty, so now it's time to wrap. So basically, you're gonna just wrap it like I've shown make any normal wraps or burritos before. You wanna kind of fold on the insides here, fold in these corners, and then try and make sure all of the insides of the burrito remain inside. And just roll it kind of like that. It's gonna be messy because, you know, of all the liquid in there, but that's basically close enough what it'll look like. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the other one. Alrighty, so now we're gonna go and put them back into our same pan that we cooked the quesadillas in. I just have that at medium heat with a little cooking spray. We're gonna cook them steam side down for a couple of minutes, flip it over, and then it'll be good. Have our final product. It looks really good. Obviously you could tell one of them wrapped and stayed together a lot better, but as long as I was gentle, they're still in one piece as of right now. So one of them was prettier than the other, but I'm sure they both taste the same. So I'm gonna go ahead and taste it and see how it compares to the actual quesarito. Yep. I mean, this would be hard to mess up because the ingredients are pretty simple, but honestly, this is really good. If anything, it might be better because this is significantly bigger than a normal quesarito. I feel like sometimes with a quesarito, I get this plus other things to fill me up, and this is like a pretty hefty size burrito. So definitely recommend this recipe. I followed it basically exactly as the one down below, so I'll link that, but if you just watched my video, the steps are pretty simple, so you can probably just throw it together yourself. But definitely recommend this, especially if the quesarito is disappearing from the menu or disappearing from some menus or whatever the rumors are true. But I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. As always, if you have any questions on the recipe, feel free to leave those in comments down below. Make sure you follow me on Instagram if you have not already. I post different content throughout the week as well as channel updates whenever I'm not uploading a video, all that kind of good stuff. If you're new to my channel and haven't yet subscribed, make sure you go ahead and subscribe so you don't miss out on any of the videos that I post on Wednesdays and Sundays. Thanks again for watching Mork's Menu, and I hope you have a great day. Bye, guys.